Mahanadi originates. Mahanadi originates from Dandkaranya Hills. Dandkaranya Hills. It's 860 kilometers long river. 860 kilometers long river. 860 kilometers long river makes delta. It makes delta in north of Chilika Lake. North of Chilika Lake. Chilika Lake is a shallow depression which has lies in Odisha. North of Chilika Lake. Hirakud Dam. H-I-R-A-K-U-D. Hirakud Dam constructed on. Hirakud Dam constructed on Mahanadi River. Constructed on Mahanadi River. Hirakud Dam constructed on Mahanadi River. First off. Next, Kaveri. Kaveri River. Kaveri River. Kaveri River. This is Asna Mahanadi. Now Kaveri River. Kaveri River originates from. Kaveri originates from. Kaveri originates from Brahmagiri Ranges. Brahmagiri. Kaveri originates from Brahmagiri. Brahmagiri. Brahmagiri ranges in Sahyadris or Western Ghats. Western Ghats are known as the Sahyadris. From Sahyadris, Brahmagiri ranges of Sahyadris in Jog Falls. Through the Jog Falls, the highest waterfall of India, Jog Falls, J-O-G, Jog Falls in Karnataka, Jog Falls in Karnataka, through which the Kaveri originates, it drains, Kaveri drains Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, Kaveri drains Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu. It flows eastward. Kaveri flows eastward. Kaveri flows eastward. Kaveri flows eastward for a distance of. For a distance of 800 kilometers before it empties in the Bay of Bengal. The river is unique. Kaveri River is unique because it receives rainfall. Kaveri receives rainfall through summer and winter monsoons. Summer and winter monsoons. Why we call it Sastra unique? Because it receives the water through the advancing monsoon season. Such winds which starts to move from a south towards north. south towards north. It caused a rainfall in Tamil Nadu, through which, and the winters also. Winters means the retreating monsoon winds. Retreating monsoon winds. Those winds, which earlier as the southwest monsoon winds, they later in stage again move from a now north towards a south. Earlier they moving from the south towards a north, but now during the months of October, November, December, such winds retreat. They again move in a back north towards the south. So Kaveri is unique because it is only the one and only river of India which receives rainfall through, which receives rainfall through winter and summer monsoons. Summer and winter monsoons. Kaveri is also known for their sacred importance. Kaveri River, known for its religious importance, sacred importance, religious importance. Mettur Dam, M-E-T-T-U-R, Mettur Dam, M-E-T-T-U-R, Mettur Dam, constructed on this river, in Tamil Nadu. Mettur Dam, constructed on Kaveri River in Tamil Nadu, Clear? Now the last river, Krishna. Till there any doubts? Anybody having any questions regarding it? Till Kaveri, Godavari and Mahanadi. Till Kaveri, Godavari, Mahanadi, the eastward flowing rivers. Any questions? Yes, Jia. Am I audible? Jia, Lakshay. Yes, any of the questions regarding
sir, आपकी वॉइस और स्क्रीन विजिबल नहीं है.
टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम बच्चे. एनी क्वेश्चंस? सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू. कृष्णा रिवर, कृष्णा इज द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट eastward flowing river. Mitansh, am I audible? Krishna is the second largest eastward flowing river. Krishna River is the second largest eastward flowing river, which originates from Mahabaleshwar. Mahabaleshwar in Western Ghats, In Western Ghats, Krishna originates from Mahabaleshwar in Western Ghats. It's 1400 kilometers long river. 1400 kilometers long river. 1400 kilometers long river. Long river has been dammed near Shri Salem. Shri Salem to form the Nagarjuna Sagar Reservoir, Nagarjuna Sagar Reservoir. The important tributaries of Krishna are Bhima and Tungbhadra. Tungbhadra is the largest tributary. Tungbhadra River and Bhima River are the tributaries of Krishna River. The Krishna River forms a large delta which covers 120 kilometers long distance on coast of Bay of Bengal. Clear? Yes, there.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, आपने कहा था जैसे कृष्णा रिवर इज द सेकंड लार्जेस्ट ईस्टवर्ड फ्लोइंग रिवर व्हिच ओरिजिनेट्स फ्रॉम महाबलेश्वर. सर महाबलेश्वर की स्पेलिंग बता दो.
MAHA महाबलेश्वर. क्लियर धैर्य. महाबलेश्वर.
यस सर.
यस धैर्य.
थैंक यू सर.
सॉरी. यस नाउ द धीरेन. यस एनी क्वेरी. सो लेट्स कंटिन्यू. Mahabaleshwar, it originates from the Mahabaleshwar. It's the second largest river of peninsular India. The largest river is Godavari, which is also known as Dakshina Ganga. Now the Krishna River, which originates from Mahabaleshwar, it fall in Bay of Bengal or makes the delta in Andhra Pradesh. Krishna makes its delta in Andhra Pradesh. It is known for the largest delta comprised by the Krishna on a coast of Bay of Bengal. It's a 120 kilometers long. Clear? These were the eastward flowing. Yes, Dhiren.
Sir, Tungabhadra is the largest tributary of India or its largest tributary of Krishna?
Of Krishna.
Okay.
Krishna having their two of the tributaries, Bhima and Tungabhadra. Tungabhadra is the largest tributary of Krishna River. On this tributary, Tungabhadra River Valley Project constructed in Maharashtra. Tungbhadra River Valley Project. Tungbhadra River Valley Project constructed on Tungbhadra River. Constructed on Tungbhadra River. And Nagarjuna Sagar Dam constructed on Nagarjuna Sagar Dam constructed on Krishna River in Andhra Pradesh. Krishna River in Andhra Pradesh. Clear? These are all the major river systems. At the earlier, we discussed as a two broader river system, Himalayan River System and Peninsular River System. Himalayan River System divided into Indus River System, Ganga River System, and third Brahmaputra River System. In the other side, Peninsular River System divided into two parts, westward flowing rivers, which includes Narmada, Tapi, Sabarmati, Luni, and Mahi, five of the rivers in westward flowing rivers. Now in the eastward flowing rivers, Kaveri, Krishna, Mahanadi, and Godavari. Mahanadi and Godavari. Mahanadi and Godavari. Mahanadi and Godavari. So these four rivers are the eastward flowing rivers. Now our next topic is the lakes. L-A-K-E-S. Done this, everybody? Now the lakes. Lake is what? Lake refers to lakes. Lake refers to a depression. The depression filled with water. Lake is a depression which is filled with water on the earth's surface is entirely surrounded by landmass. So lake is a water body which surrounded by landmass. A large water body which is surrounded by landmass is known as lake. Example, Mansarovar, Dal, Vullar, so many number of examples are there. Dal, D-A-L, Dal, Vullar, W-U-L-A-R, Vullar, Mansarovar. Sukhna is also a lake. So as per the importance, we can categorize the lakes into different categories. As per the uses, their formation, we can classify the lakes into different categories. But before of it, all over the world, the larger water bodies, the large extent of water bodies, which surrounded by the land masses, means they are lies in continents. They are presently known as the sea. For example, Caspian Sea in Europe. It can be asked the example of a lake because it is surrounded by landmass. Caspian Sea, surrounded by landmass. Clear? So as per the importance and formation, lakes can classify into four categories. First, freshwater lakes. Clear? Second are the tectonic lakes. As per the uses and formation of lakes, they can classify into four categories: freshwater lakes, tectonic lakes, third, saltwater lakes, and last, man-made or artificial lakes. So let's start about such categories of lakes. First, freshwater lakes. Most of the freshwater lakes originates from Himalayas. They are found in Himalayas. They are of glaciated areas. Freshwater lakes, glaciated areas. Glacier is an important agent of dash forces. GR, complete the blank. Glaciers are generally considered under GR Chopra. Glaciers are generally considered under the dash category of forces. In second chapter of geography, we read the two types of forces. Yes, Jia. Jia.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Glaciers are the agents of dash forces. Dash forces. Gia Lauder. Gia.
The Himalayan forces.
No, it's not the Himalayan forces. Yug Sharma. Yug. Yug, do you know the answer?
Sir, no.
That's why you are raising your hands. So these are the external forces, exogenic forces, forces which work above the surface of earth crust. In second chapter of geography, we discussed the two kinds of forces: internal forces which work beneath the layers of earth crust, forces which act on the surface of earth crust as the exogenic or external forces, which includes wind, water, glaciers, and sea waves. So glaciers act on a surface of the earth crust. Glacier is what? This is as a frozen form of a river. So such ice, the big size of a glacier, when it slides along the slopes of mountains, it eroded the big boulders. It also eroded and pushed such boulders towards the low-lying areas of mountains. And glacier melts, and that melted water, it accumulated in a central depressions known as fresh water lakes. Water melted from the glaciers, it flowed through the smaller streams and moved towards their common center. That depression may be a valley. So the water accumulated in a central part lies in between of a mountain hills is known as the freshwater lakes. Remember radial pattern which we discussed at the beginning of a chapter. Radial pattern in which the different streams of water coming from different directions towards common center, which is also known as a centripetal pattern formed by river. So their example is a Dal Lake. D-A-L, Dal Lake is the example of freshwater lake. I'm repeating again. Freshwater lakes are generally found in a Himalayan region. These are of the glaciated origins. A glacier is one of the important agents of erosion. The erosion processes of glaciers can create fresh water lakes. The melting of a glaciers can create fresh water lakes in mountains. Example, Dal Lake. Clear? Dal Lake in Jammu and Kashmir. Is that clear? So this much for today.